And as far as miracles, he said that there are people who put their faith and many things are happening in their life. But that's what I am saying. If something is happening and you know that idol is not that God and you know that it is the true Almighty God who's helping you, won't you be responsible that even when God helped you, you still cling to that idol? Because God does not want you to do that. One, why those prayers get answered? One of the names of Allah, of God Almighty in the Quran is Ar-Rahman. That He is the most merciful and He is the merciful to everybody. Whether you are a believer, whether you worship idol, whether you do not worship idol. He is merciful to everybody. So if you cry to Him, whether in front of an idol or something, He will give you. He will give you. He is very merciful. But He will hold you accountable on the day of judgment for that. So every time when He is giving you something and yet you are sticking to that principle, then we say, see brother, in this case you will be held accountable. See, you got something, you prayed to God, yet you cling to that ideology. But if somebody wants to do it, he says, there is no compulsion in religion. Allah says in the Quran in Surah Al-Baqarah chapter number 2 verse number 256, La ikraha fid din, there is no compulsion in religion. Qad tabayyana ar-rushdu min al-ghayy, that the truth stands out clear from error. You cannot compel anybody. So that's the thing.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Gaurav. Anybody in the audience who has anything to say about this perspective? Yes, sir. No, you can speak from there, the mic is.
As we believe, it is only the initial step. To climb the 100th step, you have to pass through the first step. In the creation of God, as there are so many types of livings, all are not with same intelligence and knowledge. Likewise, among the human beings, based on his karma, there are different people. For a few, the concept God, the imagination of God, maybe at a higher level. But for a common man, as we learn bicycle, first we have to cross the tricycle. Then only we have to go for the bicycle. So, it is not the only way in Hinduism to see and worship God through the idol. In yajna, we see God. Yaga yajna, we see. In prayer, we see God. Bhajan, there is nothing. So, like Islam, we have that one. But my only concept, we cannot generalize. It is on the basis of his own will and feeling, he can pursue or he can imagine God as per Hindu thinking.
Right. The brother said, again he is saying that we have to go from one level to another. So, brother Gaurav, do you have anything to say about, I mean, the logic that you gave about, you still clinging on to the idol even after God provides for you.
As far as brother is concerned, I 100% agree with what he said. He said, don't generalize. So I am saying that how can you generalize that all the Hindus are on a lower level? That they can't reach that higher level. That's what I am saying. My point is not that, I am saying no compulsion in religion. You want to do it, you do it. Islam does not say that you have to compel. But my point is, I take your point that don't generalize that all the Hindus, I can't believe this, that all the Hindus are on the lower level of consciousness.
All,
or
all won't worship God.
That's so what I am saying. But majority, that's what, majority.
You said that all Hindus
sir,
are.
Sir, one second. Let him finish answering, then we'll come back to you.
So even I am not ready to agree that the majority of the Hindus are in the lower consciousness. That does not appeal to my mind. Because you people are intelligent people. I can't say that you people are in a lower consciousness of mind. You don't have that spiritual level. Majority of the people, I can't say that. So,
yes, sir.
We believe in total freedom. It is not the higher elevated level or that such a freedom is given in Hinduism, whether through the idol or yajna or by prayer, you can. It is on the basis of just because someone is performing the idol worship, we never say that they are lower level. That concept is wrong.
Yeah.
According to you, no, don't. We can't generalize. Yeah. Such a freedom is given in Hinduism. Suppose I get a satisfaction, I see God through an idol, why not I do it? Why should I compel? Only through the higher level you have to do it. So that freedom of worship is given in Hinduism.
Thank you. Dr. Bhatt, I mean, initially when we were speaking, you said, I mean, we also agreed that, you know, he said, Nachasya Pratima Asti, there is, of him there is no images. So how does this actually correspond to, you know, having a power in the idol and everything, and a form?
See, the first thing is, we went up to idol worship and high, low, etc. Then I have to go back to Vedas once again. Okay. In Nirukta, it has been mentioned very clearly. The Nirukta means the interpretation of Vedic mantra, especially Ruks. Sakshatruta dharmano rushayo babhuhu. Te avarebhyo asakshatrutebhyo imam grantham samam nasishuhu. Is the statement there. See, many, many thousands of years ago, there were seers. Inverted comma, seers means one who can see, perceive. Okay. They were seeing it, viewing it, not just by this barren eyes, they were viewing it. What is God, what is normal, all these things, etc. Everybody, everything. It has, of course, agreed by even Arya Samaja and everybody in this
way. But what I was
Dharma.
Trying to
yes, no, no, no. I have to come to that. You have told that one. For that purpose, I have to come from Vedas only. Right. You may be remembering that in each and every point, I have started from Vedas. Yeah. Okay? So, the second is, asakshatrita dharmebhyo. When they saw that the forward generation, they could not understand or they could not view, for them, they have started to chant, tell. So, that becomes Shruti. They heard it. When they heard it, immediately they have understood it. And after some thousands of years, the people could not even interpret the Vedas, how it is, what it is. For that purpose, this Nighantu, Nirukta, etc. has been written. Before that, nothing written, etc. Only sound was there. And regarding creation, and you have mentioned regarding God, no? Quite audacious. See, in Nasadiya Sukta, 10th Mandala, Nasadasit, Nosadasit, Tadanim, Nasit, Rajono, Vyoma, Paroyat. Nisat, Tasat, etc. All these contextual I have mentioned. Before that, no, nothing was there. That inquiry and inquiry, both were there. And Kamas, Tadagre, Samavarta, Sadhan. Then desire came up, then creation started.
Right.
And,
no, but what you I was trying to get at is, yeah. See, because the Vedas say that there is, of him there is no
yes,
image.
Yes, that coming,
how can you
coming.
Images
no images,
him?
No. They have not mentioned that one. See, there was no image worship. No image worship. It was not at all there. First, Tapa was there, Japa was there, as he already mentioned, Yajna was there in Yajna form.
Yes.
Because Vedas chanting,
yes.
That when we chant, that form occurs there. Or form occurs there. It has been proved now also. If you chant that oral, that it comes,
right.
It has been proved now. For that purpose. And then, see, different views have come, different ideas have come, the time have changed, all these things. So that has come. And that when Shrine Punya Dharma Punya Loka Vishanti is not Papa. He is not bankrupt or he is not in debt. Only balance is not there. He can earn also. And just like in some Puranas, I agree with you, species, etc. It is not like that. He may come, see, there is no sin. Punya reduced. He may become person also. There is no, this person should be like this, that, etc.
Okay. Okay,
so, idol worship regarding that one, it is Puranic and it is not opposed to Vedas also. The Vedas never barred worshipping God in any form.